What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix the problem when you are unable to restore your WhatsApp chat history on your iPhone or iPad. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. First, you should make sure that WhatsApp is enabled in your iCloud backup settings. Open up your iPhone settings. Here, select your Apple ID name and proceed to your iCloud storage settings. Scroll down and verify that WhatsApp is enabled to be backed up in your iCloud. If you are short on available storage, then you might want to make room for your current WhatsApp storage requirement. Under Manage Storage, you can preview your current WhatsApp Messenger backup size. In your backups, you can, in addition, see previous device backups saved in your iCloud. If there are no backups saved here, then make sure that you're logged in with the correct Apple ID account. In some cases, the chats you wish to restore are saved on your device rather than in your iCloud. To see your saved data, open up your WhatsApp application. Here, navigate to your settings and tap on Storage and Data. Under Manage Storage, you can review and delete saved videos, photos, and individual chats. You even have the option to search for data shared with a specific contact. Back in your WhatsApp settings, tap on Chats and then Chat Backup. Here, you can select to backup your data now, and you can see your storage requirement at the top. Below, change the auto backup schedule if you want. To restore WhatsApp data using your iCloud, ensure yourself that you're using a reliable network connection. You can make use of a speed testing site or application, such as Speedtest, to see your average upload and download speed for your current connection. Depending on your settings, you're required to use a Wi-Fi connection to download or upload large files, such as backups, so make sure that you're using a Wi-Fi connection. In case nothing helps you out, then it's suggested to simply update and restart your device to make sure that this problem is not software inflicted. In your settings, tap on General, and then Software Update. Here, download and install the latest update in case there's one available to you, and proceed to restart your iPhone or iPad. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.